Hi there. My name is Liz Million and I am a children's book illustrator and author. And if you're thinking, I think I know that lady, I've been to lots and lots of schools in the Durham area and libraries as well. So you may have seen me doing my tutorials elsewhere. Now today we are going to be looking at the very serious issue of road safety. Now, road safety does not sound a very exciting topic, but it is a very, very interesting one. And it's up to us illustrators today to make it interesting and eye-catching and also memorable. Now, being an illustrator, I've had to do lots of projects like this over the years. In fact, some of them I don't even realise I've done safety things. And we're going to be talking about safety today, how to do stuff, and also how to draw things as well. Because if you're like me and you get told you have to draw somebody in a car, you might think, oh no, because I'm not very good at cars either. Now, the things that I've drawn over the years, one of my first books, Be Quiet, Belinda, in it I did a really nice car there. Look at that cool car. And we even had a little boy on his trike there with his helmet on. So even back in like 2001, I was still thinking of drawing in a safe way. I've also done books about motor cars and motorbikes called Noisy Neighbours. And this one, I had to draw a kangaroo riding a motorbike, which is really, really hard. And this book was before the internet. So let me show you. Every time I have a book, a bike on there, it is different, which it was horrendous. I had to get a bike book out and I had to draw different things. So always very safe with our helmets though. Now some pictures I've had to do for projects like this. Now this is how do you get to school? So I had to draw lots of different children getting to school. So we've got a little boy on a skateboard getting dragged along, which probably isn't very safe, but it is very eye-catching. We've got a little girl there and the mum and a baby on the back there. If you have a look here, look, oh dear, those scooters, they don't have helmets on, but this is different now. This was done a long, long time ago. So you can see all my bikes have got helmets on. And on the back, this is a lovely drawing. You can see this little boy is crossing the road with the help of a pedestrian crossing lady. And that's the sort of thing that we're going to be looking at today. We're not drawing realistic things. We are going to be drawing easy cartoon things, okay? So all the things that I need to do, if I'm drawing a book, I get ideas and inspiration about how to draw cars because I am hopeless. And sometimes it's handy to go to a library. And I found this in my little bookshelf here and have a little look. It shows how to draw towns. We're going to be looking at backgrounds as well. Look at those. These are really, really simple cars. And you can see that there's traffic lights on there. There's all sorts of things going on in there. So first of all, we're going to have a little look and a refresher about the rules that we want to represent, because there are hundreds of road safety rules and a lot of them we don't really need to know about. We just want to focus on the ones that affect you and that keep you safe. Have a look here. We have the most important to you guys, because you are pedestrians. How do you get to school? Do you have a lift every day? Do you go on the bus? Do you walk? Do you scoot? Do you cycle? There are lots of different ways of getting to school. And these are also related to how you get home from school. This time of year, you know, it's quite dark on an afternoon, isn't it? Sometimes by 3:30 in winter, it is super dark. So it's very, very important that you are seen, because cars don't see very well in the rain or the dark. And cars and vehicles don't see small kids. And that's why accidents happen every day and often with bad results. So we need to make sure you remember this for our project. So don't cross without a good view of the road. Simple ones. Don't cross on the corner or a hill. So sometimes you might not even have thought about this. Sometimes you do it automatically. And that's called a habit, when you just do things automatically. Like with me, looking left and right. I do all the time. But you know what? I got knocked over. I was all right. But I look left and right at the road end and a car just came and wiped me out. So sometimes you can do everything and it still happens. So what we want you to do is make sure you remember all this and produce some posters to maybe stop it from happening to someone else. So we've got, you could fall over if you run across roads. That is really, really good advice. Watch out for bicycle lanes. Sometimes your road have got a bicycle lane. Bikes sometimes think, I'll just go through that red light. So you need to make sure you don't cross where you can't see what's happening behind it. Don't play on or near a road. That's really important. Take notice of the traffic. Don't cross when others do. It's quite tempting to just keep going, don't you, when you see other people. Sometimes people rush and they fall over, or they'll rush and the red light will come on and green cars start going. So you need to be very, very aware. Don't just rely on your grown-ups, because sometimes grown-ups are doing other things, aren't they? So look, it says never cross when cars are coming. Kids can't judge speed. So sometimes you think, oh, that car's miles away, and you start to run across the road or walk across the road, and actually it's really, really dangerous. So when you can, try and use a lollipop person, I used to call them. School crossing patrols are fantastic, and I've done a gorgeous drawing of one for my latest story, which I'm going to show you now. And pedestrian islands, footbridges over roads, subways that go under roads, pelican, zebra, toucan crossings, they're all there. So if you can see a very busy road, it normally has one of these ways of getting across that road, okay? Because one day you're going to be really, really independent and start to cross roads yourself. And in the future, you're going to have children. You're going to pass down these rules to them. So it's very important. So if you have a look here, we've got don't cross between parked cars. That's another good one. So where to cross safely? Use crossings when you can. Green cross code as well. We've got the stop, look and listen rules. They're very important. So you look right, left, right and all around as you are crossing. Listening well. Adam Bushnell said about electric cars. Electric cars are really, really dangerous because you can't hear them coming. Noisy motorbikes, they can travel very fast as well, but you can always hear those. So take out your earpods. I know as you get older, you want to listen to music or talk to your friends on your phone, but no distractions. So definitely switch off your phones, take your earpods out and just cross the road, looking and listening all the time. No mucking about. Now I know as you get older, you'll have friends that are pushing you about and jostling. Don't do that on the road because something bad could happen. Do not run. Walk quickly and safely, because you don't want to be running into someone else, do you? Holding hands with a grown-up. I'm going to move my board down a little bit. Holding hands with a grown-up might seem like a bit babyish, but you know, it does save lives and also sets an example to other children. So little children will look up to you and think, oh, that big boy or that big girl is holding hands with another person, so maybe I should do that. So it's all about setting good example and being part of society, because that's what we have to do with rules. We all have to follow them. Sometimes grown-ups, they forget the rules and it's up to you to remind them in a nice, polite way. Don't go, Granddad, stop running across the road. Sometimes say, Granddad, we learnt at school how to cross the road safely, and I don't think we should be crossing here between two parked cars. So you just remind them. Also, peep and creep into the road if you have to. If you've got no other choice than to cross between two parked cars, peep and creep. So don't just run straight out. Peep and look out as well. So think, pause and live. So it's all about taking your time, even if you're running late, because these sorts of things here, cars don't really look for places where danger is going to happen. As a driver myself, I know when I look, I can see signs saying schools, 20 miles an hour is very important. Some silly people out there think, well, schools are shut. So they go flying past. And you know what? Some children go home for lunch. Some nurseries finish at half day. And it's just a really dangerous place to be around. So if we all followed these rules, it would be a really brilliant thing. So I'm going to show you now how to draw some pedestrian kinds of safety. So grab a pencil and a bit of paper, because I'm going to show you how to do some drawing. So I've got all my pens ready. I've got thick ones, thin ones. I've got a pencil, meow, with a little car on. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to move everything off and I'm going to leave a bit of space up here for my writing and down the bottom, because nothing worse than drawing a beautiful picture and then actually not having enough space. So very lightly
going to draw a human pedestrian. And you could do an animal one or a human one. And I'm going to just think about what sort of clothes he might be wearing and what season it is. So it might be in the summer, but I think I'm going to set it at winter. So I might have him on his phone with don't use phones when crossing roads, but I think what I'm going to do is focus on the good sort of behaviour. Okay, so I might give him big eyes and he might be looking left and right. And this could be a girl or a boy if I wanted to put eyelashes on. I think I'm going to do a boy. Now, when you are an illustrator, you have to think about what character you want. So I'm going to draw him maybe a little bit of an older boy. So he's carrying, you know, his packed lunch. Ooh, I like a good packed lunch. Nice, healthy food in. And big boys tend to have sort of rucksacks on, don't they? And he might have games after school or something. So there he is. He's alert, isn't he? He's looking. And you can see how I work. I do lots of sketchy sort of lines that I correct and go over all the time. Now he looks like he's standing still there, which I don't want, so I'm going to bend this leg and bend that leg, so it looks like he's walking fast. Now these look easy to draw, actually they're a little bit tricky. So here he is, and I want him to be on an island, maybe a pedestrian island. So he's crossing the road. And again, this is just saved for your words. So pedestrian islands have usually got two little sort of cone things here. And this means that he has crossed a road. So there'd be one road here and another road sort of here. And he's being very, very safe. We could also put some details in the background. So we've got our 20 miles an hour line here, our little sign there. Also, we could put the curb and maybe some grass, and you can add colour to this later on. You might want to also draw a bit of pavement. You can see I'm sort of doing it on little angles, can't you, very quickly. So I work everything out in my pencil and then I go round it in my pen. So I have my pen here. And the first thing I do is draw his eyes. Hello! And this is not my best drawing. This is just me showing you how to draw. You can always stop the video if you wanted to copy it. Okay. Now, sometimes I have different pens for different things. I don't think I like this pen. It's a bit squeaky. But because I want to do some thicker hair on him, might give him a bit of an emo fringe, just to show he's a bit older. Might look like someone in your class. And then I'm gonna get my skinny end like that. Now he's probably more likely to have a sort of beanie if he's older. So I might just get rid of, oops, wrong pen. Might get rid of that bobble there. He's just got a little cool beanie on. And I'm not gonna draw a scarf because normally in winter boys sometimes just wear hoodies, they always freeze, don't they? Now I have a son who is just like that. So I'm going to do some wiggles coming round here, because if you have a look, your clothes have always got little lines there where your arms go. And this arm is quite long, so because I've drawn that in pencil, I've made his arm longer. Can you see now he looks a lot older now? He's got his hand in his pocket. He might have his school uniform on underneath here, like that. And what we want is a very clear, easy to read, noticeable kind of image. So we don't want too much fuss on here. Like, I wouldn't start adding loads of squirrels, and because our message is to keep safe. It's not like, look at this squirrel, even though it is quite nice to have things in the background sometimes, especially with picture books. So look, they're different sizes and shapes. This is because our things have got little things on, so we don't really need to worry about that. Okay, background, do a curb. You can have a look at backgrounds on the internet if you wanted to learn how to draw your school, or you could draw your house. You can see I'm going over the lines a little bit there, and that's because I don't really like that pen. I'm going to put my 20 in there, and I'm then going to draw these trainers. Now, it doesn't matter if this is a different sort of thickness. Sometimes I like doing a bit thick and a bit thin, and it's finding out what sort of materials and what pens and what paints you like, because I know some people who prefer painting and that sort of thing. So there we have. He's going to be... I must get rid of that pen. I hate it. He's going to be looking. He's going to be listening. And he is walking like that. And it's up to you what sort of shoes you put on him. Now, I know you can't put Reebok or Nike or whatever on there because it would be advertising. But what he's doing is walking safely and using one of the preferred ways to cross a busy road. So he isn't running out between parked cars. He's very safely using a pedestrian crossing. And sometimes they are quite scary because you are in the middle of fast flowing traffic. And when you get older, you will be more independent. You'll have to use these on your own. And it's about being confident, but also being safe as well. So there we have our little... I think I do want to put that little bobble on just to make him look cute. You could do any colour you like. I'm going to put a little bit of dark here. And I want it to be on like a wintry sort of night. So it's quite dark, isn't it, when you walk home from school sometimes. So what I want to do now is put the reflecty kind of stuff on him. So he has got, because you don't have to have just one message, it can be two messages. So I've got a marker pen, this highlighter here, and I might do a bit of yellow on here. I might do some stripes on his little pat lunch or his book bag. He might have some high-vis stuff. Might have one of those like high-vis beanies, mightn't he, that runners use. Okay. He might have a bit of reflecty strip on his thing here. He might have some on his rucksack. And he might have a high-vis thing on there. Okay. So... so he's not stopping. We're not going to write stop, look, listen. I'm going to put look. Listen. Now, I suggest you do that in pencil because I have had many years of going wrong with that to know that I can fit that on there. Look, listen, and then down the bottom. Live. This is not my finished piece, okay? I would practice with different slogans. You might do, look both ways, save lives today, be bright, be seen. Could be anything you like, okay? So if I wanted to have a little look at my character, I would maybe draw some eyelashes on if it's a girl, and then I would obviously get my rubber and rub all those lines out. Okay, the last thing I would do is put my name on. And that is just one idea for the pedestrian safety.
I'm going to be looking at car safety after that lovely little draw along, because car safety is very important too. Now, you may think as a passenger, you don't have much to do with the overall safety of a car, but actually you're very, very important. Now, the reason why we have rules is to keep you guys safe. And who sometimes thinks, oh, it's only a little trip down the road, we won't bother wearing a seatbelt? Well, hopefully none of you, because every trip is fraught with danger. You don't know if a cat's going to run out and your grown-up's going to screech to a halt. And did you know when you're travelling on motorways, if you don't have a seatbelt in the back, if you do have an accident, you normally kill the person in front of you, which is really awful to think about. So we're not going to look too much at road safety, because the drivers do have a lot of control about that situation, but you can help out by always wearing a seatbelt. So look, clunk, click every trip. Buckle up. Don't distract the driver. Now, my son is terrible for this. He is on his phone and he's going, "Mom, watch this video. Watch this video. Look, there's a dog. Can you see the dog? Can you see it? Can you see it?" And I'm like that. "George, I am driving a car." And he thinks we're at home on settee and he wants to share stuff with me all the time. Another one, he asks me, "How do you get this song on? How do you get the Bluetooth on?" And I'm like, "I am driving the car." So don't chat to your grown-up about other things. Yes, by all means, look out of the window and say, "Oh, what a lovely car that is. Look at that flash sports car." Or, "Oh, I'm going to be doing my homework tonight." Just talking generally is absolutely fine. But don't demand that your driver gives you attention on your phones and, "Mummy, can you help me put this button back on?" No. Okay, so use your common sense. Also, dogs. Now, I have Peggy, the Bedlington Terrier, and she is just gorgeous and she loves going to the beach on walks. So we have her in the car quite a lot. Sometimes she just comes for a little trip out just to liven up her afternoon and we go, but we always click her in. So even she is clunk clicked every trip, because if you have an accident and the dog gets out onto the road, it's terrifying for other drivers and also it would put your dog in danger. So your dog needs to be kept on a lead as well in the car. The safest side of getting out of a vehicle. Now, sometimes you just think, you say, right, your mum goes, or your dad or your parent goes, "Right, you hop out here," and it's on the side of the curb, which is totally fine. You wouldn't want to get out in the middle of the road, would you, with your parent at the curb? So think about your parent and where they've parked. Also, open the door a little bit and look each way, because sometimes if you open your door, it's onto the oncoming person walking or a car as well, which is not advisable. So be aware of speed limits. If you see your grown-up going over 30 on a normal road, you tell your grown-up it's a 30, and you'll see when it's near your school, it'll go down to 20, because you are very vulnerable pedestrians and we need to keep careful of you. And sometimes they have little warning signs saying schools. So everybody should be going this sort of speed outside a school. And if they're not, they're being very, very naughty and reckless. And when you grow up to be a driver, hopefully you'll remember all these things too, because you'll get taught them when you get older. Also, be extra careful around busy times and busy towns and school areas. Now, schools are very busy first thing in the morning and when the school bell goes in the afternoon, aren't they? Also, you might have buses in front of you. You might need to sort of try and get around a bus. They're very dangerous places as well. Using the correct booster seat. So your booster seat has to be a certain size to keep your weight or your height safe. So you need to get your parents to have a little look, or your grown-ups to have a look at that. I think I've done all of those now. Slow down, don't speed. So what we want to do is have a little think about your sort of driver car experience. So we're going to have a little draw of this. Now, I am terrible at cars, but I'm going to show you an easy way of drawing a very simple idea for your posters.
Got all my pencils and everything ready. Now, this is the one I'm dreading, because I'm not fantastic at cars. Now, I know you say that you should practice when you're not good at something. I always like have to look at a physical picture of a car if I have to draw one. Now, you're probably thinking, "Oh my goodness, she really is bad at cars." And that's because it's looking a little bit like a spacecraft. But what I do is I start just putting little bits of ideas on. Now, I don't really need a massively detailed car there. It's just to give you an idea of the road safety message. Now, in there, we could draw a boy sideways or a girl sideways wearing a seatbelt like that. But I don't think that's very good for this idea. So I think what I'm going to do is don't distract the driver. So So I'm going to draw a steering wheel here, some little hands on, and again, what I'm doing, I'm going to be drawing a woman going, "What do you want?" It's normally like a harassed mum going, "What?" But I don't want her to look angry. I'm going to show the kid. The kid is, what could the kid be doing? The kid could be maybe whacking her on the head with a giant pencil or something. Yeah. We could also have the dog in there as well. Now, I don't think we've got enough room there. So what I'm going to do is just put her going like that. Now, what I want is her to be showing dangerous driving. So over here, I'm not going to have someone obviously getting squashed. She's gone through a red light on a crossing. Look at that. Oh, my word. So she's going this way. So this red light needs to be red, just to sort of remind ourselves and to draw attention to it. And this is the shock example. So we could have someone here who was just about to step over going, "What?" Looking cross. So he is just waiting there. We could have like an older sort of gentleman, couldn't we, with like a little old cap on or something. I know you're all dying for me to draw a moustache. He's going, "Hey." We could draw someone here as well, getting ready as well, couldn't we, to cross. This is going to be tricky because it's a bit of a funny angle. So you can see how I just try and work things out. So look, she's going, the kid's going, "Ha!" I think the kid's got like a balloon. She's got a big balloon. He's whacking the mum on the head. We're like, "Yeah, I've just been to have a burger. I've got a free balloon." There we go. So I'm now going to try and go around it with my pen. I'm going to start with the mum. The mum is looking like, "Oh my word, what have I just done?" And when you are a driver, it's really easy to get distracted. Okay, I'm just going to put her shoulders here like that. Her hands, I'm just going to draw coming around the wheel like that. And again, we don't need a lot of detail on here. Got a little kid here with a balloon. Now we're making him old enough to know better. We haven't got a baby there. He's going, "Yeah, let's whack mum on the head with a balloon." Remember, you could draw a person of any age here. But what we want to do is, these posters are for children, so we want you to do. He's got his arm round the seat belt and he's going, "La la la." Now his hand is going to be going down this bar here. But I want this balloon to be really like over there like that. So you can see I'm only really doing the lines that I need to do with my thin pen. Got the little handle here. While I'm over here, I'm going to do an old man. I don't want him to look too angry. I want him to look sort of shocked because he was about to cross. This guy's done everything right. Look, he's pressed his little button here. It's beeping to say cross because you're a little green man. Your little green man. And this lady has just come sailing past. So he's got his little hat on here. We give him a bigger nose to make him look older. Oi! We give him a little scarf. The good thing is though, he's got a little walking stick, and it's good to put people with different abilities on here as well. So, and another poster, I might put someone in a wheelchair or an old person or a baby. So should we put a beard on him? Yeah, come on then. Put a little moustache on him. "Oi, you crazy woman, look where you're going." Now we don't want a speech bubble saying that, even though it would be brilliant. And when you're doing a children's book, you can really sell the story like that. But we don't really need it on our poster because our poster is meant to be really bright and colourful. So I've got a really eye-catching red pen here. And she's got and sort of little funky red car. But also, when we use red, it brings the element of danger, doesn't it? There we go. Now, this pen is brand new, so I'm all right colouring in quite a big area like this with it. Now, if you've got a felt tip that isn't very good, then I'd suggest you don't use it. You use pencil crayons. You can see it's just very, very quick. Now, you do not have to do it this quickly. I am doing it quickly for our quick sort of video. And I should maybe have drawn that person in a little bit more there, but I'm not too worried about that. There we go. Now, back to my bigger pen. Here we go. And I would draw a thing like that. I would come around, make it standing out a little bit. There's the exhaust. And she is going. There we go. So I'm always looking at what I need to add. So we need our seat belts. It could be a wear your seat belt as well type of picture. This is like a sort of dark grey. So while I've got my dark grey, I might just put some wheels on. Again, I'm not worrying about drawing fantastic looking tyres or anything like that. Just to give an impression of a wheel or a tyre. So I'm going to draw a lady, I think, this time. This lady was really shocked. She was just about to cross over the road. And I'm going to get some, I might do some nice dark hair. So she's just like maybe a student or a lady with a shopping or anything you like. So I'm going to put just her shoulders on here. And she's going, oh my word, watch out. So that could have ended very differently. And this lady knows it. She is thinking, oh my goodness, what on earth was I thinking? And this colour here, I'm going to rub this little bit out. You can see I've got a lovely pink rubber here. I'm going to rub this bit out now. And you always have to let your felt tip dry if you're going around with a felt tip, because sometimes it smudges and it's really, really annoying. You can see I've got a nice little sort of picture starting here. And it started with me saying, oh, I'm rubbish at drawing cars. But actually, it's worked out fine, hasn't it? I'm going to get a really bright colour for that lovely balloon. In fact, you could do a load of balloons. Maybe they're on the way back from a party. So I'm going to get my big end here. And on the way back from a party, so I could maybe draw a few balloons. Ba-bum, ba-bum, ba-bum. Oh, bump. And her head is spinning round. That, and it might be dark. She might have her lights on. It might be raining. Oh my word, all these things, windscreen wipers going, all these things going on. And I might get my yellow. So she's coming back from a party on a Saturday afternoon. And it's got really, really dark and dreary weather. And she hasn't seen this man, because look, he's in dark clothes. She hasn't seen this lady, because she wasn't even looking. So there we go. We have a very quick picture. Okay, if you wanted to put that on your poster, you can do. Okay, she could be a teenage sister that's just learnt to drive. I've also got a stripy top. Here, a bit Where's Wally, that isn't it? Okay, so you get the idea. If you wanted to put your slogan on there saying don't distract the driver, you can do. And remember, you've got to put all different types of people on there as well. Okay, so there we go.
Important one is cycle safety, especially if you are cycling to school or you're scooting or even skateboarding. That's always good fun. It is really, really important to be seen. So be visible. Check your bike every trip. Now, there's no point just hopping on your bike putting your helmet on and going to school, if you've got a flat tire, you need to make sure your brakes are working as well, because if your brakes aren't working, you're going downhill. Also, make sure your lights are working as well. Sometimes on these gloomy nights, you might need to cycle to an after school place, or you might have to cycle around to your nana's house, and this is always very important as well. And how you can help this is use reflective high-vis products. So you've all seen those little flashy bits that go on your bike. We've got bike lights, you've even got flashy key rings that you can put on the back of your backpacks. We've got high-vis tabard as well that a lot of grown-ups use, especially on dark wintry nights. These are very, very important. Also, making sure your helmet fits correctly. Some of you have your favourite helmet, but it's from 3 years ago and your brain grows, okay? So there's no point having a helmet that starts back here. You need a new helmet that fits right onto your skull, because if you fall onto a pavement or a road, this is the impact, and this is a very, very important part of your head. Your skull is very, very thin, and your brain floats on lots of liquid to keep it from getting knocked. Okay, so I know a couple of people who've been very, very keen cyclists, and their bike has saved their life on a number of times, actually. So you also need to make sure it is a fit, safe helmet that you are wearing, and also never scoot on the road, and also be aware of people on pavements and on crossings. You do not want to be that kid that cycles fast past a really little old lady who can't hear you coming up from behind, do you? That's not very nice manners. Also, you don't want to be going right across a road when people are crossing the other way. So the best idea is to get off your bike and push, or get off your scooter and do really, really slowly. And also a good idea is to always stay near adult. I know it's quite tempting to speed ahead, but always wait at the road end, because when you're scooting along a pavement, sometimes the end of somebody's driveway is there and they might start reversing because they drive to school. So sometimes it's very, very important to be very careful and stay near your grown-up, because your grown-up is really clever and they're looking to try and keep you safe all the time. They're thinking, oh, there's a car there, there's a bike here. Motorbikes as well, they come flying out of nowhere sometimes. So if you're seen, that is best to be seen to be safe, okay? So all this thing here, be bright, be seen, be safe, be seen, be aware, be visible. This is another brilliant way of keeping you safe. So we are going to do some more drawing, so grab your pencils.
So we are going on to cyclist safety now. Have you ever tried to draw a bike before? It is not easy. We could easily do skateboarder or scooter. They're a little bit easier, but I want to challenge you to drawing a cyclist. So instead of just choosing the easy option, I'm going to show you how to draw the bike itself as well. And I'm going to do it in a cartoony way, so don't worry if it doesn't go 100% right. Okay, I'm coming round here. I'm going to chop the top of his head off, because this is going to be his helmet. Very important. And his ear, he's going to be turning his face a little bit that way, so we can see one ear more than the other ear. There we go. And this time I'm going to do a girl. So she doesn't look very pretty at the moment. She looks a little bit ugly, but we need to make sure that this is fitted onto her head. So you can see again, I'm doing my funny little lines to make sure that I've got it all drawn out correctly. Now, cycling is a funny thing. You've got legs going everywhere, and you've also got pedals as well. We want it to be about her being seen or being safe with her helmet. So I might give her a thinner arm here. And your bikes are really hard. Okay, I'm going to just show you how to do a sort of frame. So this frame here goes there, and then you've got your seat. So you go straight across there. Then this bit comes around here. This is horrible, by the way, drawing this in front of all you lot. And then there's a frame that comes here with that pedal on. Then there's somehow another frame here and another frame there. I mean, this is not good, is it? I would then get a proper circle to draw around, but it's only you, so I'm just going to guess. Oh, that's actually not too bad, right? Now, I've been an illustrator for a long time, and even I am struggling with this. Okay, now handlebars would come round like this. Now, this, I don't know what kind of a bike she's got, apart from it being a rubbish one. But all I'm going to do is very simply get my big pen and just do that. So it looks like more of a bike than it actually is, and without any detail on. I'm going to put some reflection bits with my highlighter pen that I used on the pedestrian video. And these are brilliant. You can have them on key rings, dangling off your bag. I'm going to draw her wearing, wearing a high-vis tabard. Because if you have to do your cycling proficiency, you would have to wear one of these. And it just means that you are seen, which is a really, really important part of our road safety campaign. So she could also have a little reflecty band. She could have some on the end of her pedals. And then I'm going to get my pen, and I'll get this pen. I'm going to change her eyes a little bit, actually. So I'm going to have some quite cute eyes. And your eyes are all different, and I've got lots of sheets for you. Show you how to draw eyes, and I'm going to make her a bit more smiley. So she's doing everything right. She's happy and she is safe, more importantly. I'm going to give her a little ear here, and more of a pointy chin. And her little eyebrows are going up. And her helmet comes right up around here. Remember, we need to have it fitted safely and correctly. I'm going to get my black pen, and I'm going to put the strap coming around here and under her chin a little bit. Now, don't worry if you're thinking this is horrendous to draw. Why is Liz getting us to draw this? I'm simply showing you, you don't have to draw this. You can see I've left a little gap there for her bow, and she can have one or two. But if she's going quite fast that way, the other one would be behind her head. You could draw one there, but I think it adds a bit of movement. I'm going to come around here. She's got her wristband on that's very reflecty, and I'm just going to put a sort of cartoon hand on there. So that's the sort of handlebar. So you can see I'm not worrying too much about making it look realistic. She's got one leg there like that. And I might draw her foot pointing down because it would be on her pedal. And the pedal's got a shiny bit on there. And you can draw that coming off here. Now, we're not going to worry about putting chains and brakes and things. This is a very, very simple cartoony drawing. In fact, this looks a bit like a sort of square with a line on, doesn't it? So if you wanted to have a go at that, you can maybe have a go. And there's no harm in asking for help if you wanted someone to help you draw. I used to be the person everyone asked in my class to help draw. People would say, Liz, can you help me draw this? And I'd love it. So if you've got a good drawer in your class, you can always ask them nicely, can't you? So a few spokes. Oh, can you see that pen's run out? That's because I've been chatting to you a lot. Some little spokes. I'm doing that with my, it's a black pencil crayon. There we are. So not too bad in the end. Some reflecty bits on there. Now we need some action lines. Her other leg, by the way, would be sort of here. Don't really need to know about that. If you wanted to draw her with a shadow on here like that, some dark trousers on. She could have a school jumper on or a cardigan, couldn't she? Depends what colour yours is. I've got a nice sort of green here. Sometimes they're bottle green. And it would be a little bit under there because she's got a little tabard on. So she might have little shiny bits here and there. And to show she's moving fast or going forward, we've got little action lines like that. Now, don't put them too near her bottom. We don't want her to be wind powered. And I've got a nice blue here, and I might give her a nice bright blue helmet like that. And you don't need to worry about using expensive marker pens. Yours is going to be just brilliant, I know it. And she's got little trainers on. Okay, now I always do little rosy cheeks. If you wanted to do a flesh colour on there, you can do. And now look, if I rub all those practice lines out, you can see it looks a lot neater, doesn't it? So it's easy to draw it in pencil and then go around it. Now we need to have a bit of a background. Now, is she old enough to go on the road? Has she done her cycling proficiency yet? Is she going across a crossing? Should she be going across a crossing if she is on her bike, or should she get off it? So all these things you need to think about. So I think to get away from her maybe being on the road, I'm gonna make it look like she's just on a curb, or she could actually be on a sort of cycle path, couldn't she? There she is, so she's going really nice. I might also put a 20 here, just to remind people of the restrictions. So you can only go up to 20 miles an hour because she's on the way to school. So if she's on the way to school, she might have her little rucksack, or she might be on the way home from school, because either way, on the night time or an early morning, it is quite dark. So while we're doing that, she could have her little flashy badge. So you can see I'm choosing different pens for different jobs, and she is very, very safe and seen. And we also want it to be about wearing a helmet. And these pens are great because they do let me. So it could be safe, be seen. Wear a helmet. So really, we're giving quite a few different messages on there, aren't we? It's about being seen, it's about being safe, it's about going carefully, it's about being aware of your surroundings, it's also about wearing a helmet. So we've actually managed to get quite a few messages in, and I'm sure you'll be able to do that with yours as well. I'll just put her little rucksacky bit around there, and there we go.
Rightio. So when it comes to actually doing your poster, it's quite a good idea to do portrait like this one here. Now, this is one I did for a school yonks ago, really, really long time ago, but actually the message is still very, very simple. Be safe, be seen. So I've chosen a slogan. I've also got a little character here. That could be a human, it could be an animal. I've also got another animal there with lights on, and he's got a little reflective thing. He's got shiny bits on, so he's doing everything right. He's using our crossing. You could do one simple like this, or you could just choose one of these slogans. Now, a slogan is a saying that gets in people's heads. So we've got very obvious ones like stop, look and listen. Even I remember that from when I was a little girl. And I've also put live on there as well, because that is more important than anything. Keep our kids safe. Don't speed. So what this is probably to all the drivers, a message to the drivers. So what poster do you want to make? Who is it going to be for? Is it going to be for other children? Is it going to be for parents to take notice? Is it going to be an advisory one? We don't want one saying, don't speed or else. That isn't very nice. And actually, research has shown if people get rewarded and nicely spoken to, they're more likely to react well to a campaign. So we don't want anyone saying, don't be a Wally and speed. We want to be like, be cool in school. Like, don't be a fool outside school. Be cool. Wear your helmet, check your bike. So all advice instead of telling somebody off. And I did another project for Durham Road Safety, and these are the sorts of ideas that we looked at. So we looked at sort of promoting 20 miles an hour. We also looked at the different types of people that you would get in a town or a city. And obviously there's lots of different types of buildings. So what we did, we looked at all these different types of posters that we could create in a friendly way. advisory kind of way. So we've got look out, kids about, and we've got be safe, be seen, be visible always. So all the things we've been looking at, pedestrian safety, car safety, bike and scooter safety, these are all linked in. Look, clunk, clunk, every trip, don't distract your driver, road safety matters. So be bright, be seen. That could be a big bright flamingo with a high-vis helmet on a scooter. Your imaginations are fantastic. And I want you to create your own characters, but I've also got lots of sheets as well for you to download and to keep forever and ever. So you could also use it for other projects as well. And these are animal sheets, human sheets, and these sorts of sheets here. This probably took me about 3 hours to draw, and you're thinking 3 hours, you don't need to spend 3 hours because I've done most of the hard work for you. So if you have a look here, it has stop, look, listen, live. So it has actually got some of the slogans on there, and it's also got how to cross the road and how to draw people holding hands and how to draw people driving as well, because that is quite tricky. So basically everything we have seen today. So I would like to say a massive thank you and well done. Your drawings, I can't see them, but I imagine that they are really, really brilliant. And don't worry if yours haven't gone perfectly well. Your brain has never drawn them before. Now, I have been an illustrator for a long, long time, 23 years. This picture here did not take me very long to do because I'm very confident. I know what I'm drawing. But if I was doing a project like this that I hadn't done before, I would research using those books that I showed you before about how to draw towns, how to draw easy cars. You're very lucky you've got the internet as well. So if you wanted to draw, a penguin crossing the road, you can do. And if I haven't got it on the sheet, you can easily research how to draw a penguin. It is endless, our project. And remember, what sort of poster would you like to see in your school or up and around? Or you could even pop it in your window. Would you like a beautiful unicorn crossing the road, all bright and colourful? Would you like to do a family of dragons, like in a car safely buckled up? Would you like to draw people as well? So it's totally open-ended and it's totally up to you. So think about what message you want to say, think about what characters you are going to use, and think about your slogan. Keep it catchy. Don't put too much wording on there. And also, bubble writing is hard, remember. Bubble writing is tricky. So if you wanted to use a computer, you can do. Okay, so thank you ever so much. I have had a brilliant time showing you how to draw. You could also go home and do more of these and show people in your family. And then when you've done your posters, you can then remind all those people in your school what you have to do concerning road safety. So my name is Liz Million. I'd like to say a big thank you and best of luck. Bye.